Good morning, students. So in this video, I will be discussing you IP first year exam important questions from chemistry. So section one, section A, you have to answer all the questions. It will be 2 marks. So 2 into 10 will be 20 marks. So write the biological importance of calcium and magnesium. This is an important question from S block element. Calcium and magnesium, as you know, calcium helps in blood clotting. Calcium is present in bones and teeth. Magnesium is also present in some of the enzymes, very useful. So keep this in mind. Write to any 2 uses of caustic soda, so that from the same chapter you have to remember the 2 uses of caustic soda. Write to crystalline allotropes of carbon. As you know, carbon shows a lot of allotropy, most important in diamond and graphite. In diamond, the carbon is sp3 hybridized, whereas in graphite it is sp2 hybridized. Graphite has double bond character like benzene, and it's a good conductor. So carbon being a non-metal, graphite acting as a conductor, so unique thing. Diamond is hard because of its covalent bonding, that you know, 3-dimensional. So it's hard. What are the effect of acid rain? Very important question from acid rain. Every year they are asking. So keep this in mind, student, acid rain. Okay. Next question is calculate kinetic energy. Just remember the formula, kinetic energy equal to N 3 by 2 NRT. So based on this, you can simply write, convert the temperature in Kelvin. Convert the temperature in Kelvin. The empirical formula. So empirical formula related questions are being asked every time I am seeing this. So you have to remember that N is equal to molecular formula mass by empirical formula mass. And you have to remember that molecular formula is equal to N into empirical formula. Based on this, you will be able to answer. So here 90 is given and the empirical formula mass is 12. 12 plus 2, 14. 14 plus 2, 30. That is 3. So you have to multiply with 3 with CH2. Oh, so it will become C3H6O3. This will be the molecular formula. Greenhouse effect, you know what is greenhouse effect, the increase in the amount of carbon dioxide leads to greenhouse. So concentration of H plus ion is given and pH is asking. So pH is equal to minus log H plus ion concentration. Log base will be 10, so you can easily find out, but you have to know the logarithmic part. So you can check my other video where I have discussed logarithm. You have to write the UPEC name, so very easy to write the UPEC name. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 2, 3, trimethyl pentane. Here priority is given to COOH, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 3 dimethyl, 3, 3 dimethyl butanoic acid. So this way you have to name the organic compound. So these were the very short question type. Okay, now coming to your short answer type question, section B. So section B, first question is, derives Charles' law and Graham's law of diffusion from kinetic gas. So you have to remember the kinetic gas equation. This is from gas law. So you have to remember, this is a very important question. Balance the following redox. Every time they are asking one balancing of redox reaction. So if you master that balancing of redox reaction, there is a video in my channel, not only 1 or 2 video, you will find where balancing of redox reaction I have discussed. So very easily you can do it with ionic. First you have to write the oxidation number, and then you have to see the change in the electron, and then you have to balance oxygen and hydrogen, and this is in acidic medium, so you need to add H plus. And then check for charge. If you have checked for charge, then that means it is a correct equation if the charge on both sides are equal. Hess law of constant heat summation. Hess law states that whether a chemical reaction occurs in one step or two step or more than one step, the enthalpy change remains the same. So you have to give the carbon dioxide as an example. Next, the relation between Kp and Kc for equilibria. As you know, Kp equal to Kc into Rt to the power delta n. So you have to find out the delta n for this equation. Delta n is C plus D minus K plus B. So based on this, you can find out the delta and put the value, and you will get the relation between Kp and Kc. What is hardness of water? Very important question from hydrogen chapter. Hardness of water, Calgon method. Calgon means calcium gone. Calgon means calcium gone. So you have to keep this in mind. Sodium hexametaphosphate, so how it removes the calcium ion and magnesium ions, you have to remember the reaction. The structure of diboron has been discussed in my channel. It has a banana bond, so it has 2 3-center 2-electron bond, and it has 4 2-center 2-electron bond. So that's a very important structure, and boron is sp3 hybridized here. So this is a very important question. Now you have to remember the 2 methods of preparation of ethylene. How ethylene is prepared, give 2 equations. So this is from your organic chapter, hydrocarbon. So you prepare a student. Next is how are following up in from nitrobenzene. So if you do the nitration of benzene, you will get nitrobenzene. If you do the nitration of benzene, you will get nitrobenzene. How you will form methyl benzene? So if you do Friedel-Crafts alkylation of benzene, you will get methyl benzene. So you have to write the equation with the catalyst and proper condition. So this is important from hydrocarbon chapter. So these both questions come from hydrocarbon organic chemistry. Now coming to section C, which you have to answer two questions. So 2 × 8 marks, that is 60 marks you will get. So what are quantum numbers? So a set of number which give complete address of an electron in an atom. So there are four different types of quantum number: principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number, spin quantum number. You have to know the significance of a quantum number, which is related to energy, which is related to radius, which is related to the shapes of the orbital, which is related to the interaction of electron with magnetic field. So this you will come to know about the quantum number. What is first and second ionization enthalpy? So you have to define ionization enthalpy properly, then you have to write the first ionization enthalpy, then second, and you always know that the successive values of ionization energy keeps on increasing because it is difficult to remove electrons from a positively charged cation. So second ionization energy is higher than, and what are the factors which affect ionization enthalpy? You see the atomic size, the configuration, the penetration power. So these are the factors, screening effect, etc. So this is a very important question. These are important questions, long questions, long answer question type. Explain coordinate covalent bond. So you know that a coordinate covalent bond or coordinate bond is just similar to a covalent bond, but the donor atom donates both the electrons for sharing, like ammonium ion has a coordinate bond. Okay, nitric acid has coordinate bond. Nitrogen, when it forms four bonds, one is coordinate, three is covalent. So you have to keep in mind. Hybridization is the mixing of atomic orbital to form hybrid orbital. And sp3 hybridization, you just have to follow PCl5, you have to mention. It's strictly given in your Telugu Academy book as well as in NCRT. So you have to just explain the sp3 hybridization, and you already know the structure of PCl5. It has axial, these are equatorial bond, and this is the axial bond. The axial bonds are larger, whereas the equatorial bonds are smaller. So this is trigonal bipyramidal. So this you have to explain in detail with writing their orbital configuration. So this was the important question, student, I found from a model paper. So I hope this will be really helpful for you. So do like and subscribe my channel for more such videos. This is Sandeep Sir signing off. All the very best to all of you. Just believe in yourself and work hard, and you will get what you desire. That is 60 out of 60. So wishing you grand success for your upcoming exam. Thanks for watching this video. Stay blessed, stay happy. Bye.